So we have this girl right over here, and she is 1.7 meters tall, and she's standing in the sun, and the sun's at an angle with respect to the ground. The sun is at an angle with respect to the ground. And given where the sun is right now, her shadow is 3.1 meters long. What I want you to do is pause this video and try to figure out that angle of the sun relative to the ground. Or another way, let me be a little bit more specific. Pause the video and try to figure out what this angle is and figure it out in terms of radians. So as you might imagine, this we have an angle, and then we have the lengths of two sides, and we could figure out the ratios of the lengths of sides. So this might be involving a little bit of trigonometry. And which of our trig functions, if we're talking about this angle right over here, which of our trig functions deal with the opposite and the adjacent? Well, we could remind ourselves with a little bit of SOHCAHTOA. Sine is opposite over hypotenuse. Cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse, and tangent is opposite over adjacent. Opposite over adjacent. So tangent is what we would use. It's dealing with opposite and adjacent. So we could say that the tangent of theta is equal to 1.7 meters over 3.1 meters. Over 3.1 meters. So we need to figure out some angle theta in radians, where if I take the tangent of it, I'm going to get 1.7 over 3.1. Or another way we could think about it, we could take the inverse tan function or tangent function of both sides of this, sometimes called the arc cosine, sometimes called the arc tangent. So if we take the inverse tangent of both sides of this, we are going to be left with theta is equal to the inverse tangent of 1.7 over 3.1. And this isn't something that's very easy to kind of look at the unit circle and try to figure out what this is going to be. So let's just use our calculator for this one. So let's see, we want to take the inverse tangent. So give me the angle whose tangent is the number that I'm, the argument that I'm going to give to this inverse tangent function. The inverse tangent of 1.7 over 3.1. And before I even press enter here, let me make sure I'm in the right mode. So no, I'm not in the right mode. So I was in degree mode. Let me go into radian mode. We said that we wanted the answer in radians. So let's exit from this. And now we are going to get our answer in radians. And so if we were to round to the nearest hundredths, this would give us about pretty close to 0.50. So this is approximately equal to 0.50 if we round to the nearest hundredths. That's the measure of this angle in radians. I could write 0.50 radians.